Hi everyone, my name is Vin and I'm a program manager on the SQL Server engineering team. And in this video, we're going to talk about SQL Server 2019 in containers, as well as how you can get started with these containers. Let's get to it. So for starters, let's take a look at the brief history of SQL Server containers. In 2017, we released our first SQL Server containers where we had regularly released containers for each CU, and they were all based on Ubuntu 16.04. In 2019, we're continuing to do a lot more with containers, and here are a few points that highlight some of those areas. We are offering SQL Server 2019 containers based off of Red Hat, Ubuntu, and Windows. We're also adding more feature areas to SQL Server on Linux containers, and some of these areas include machine learning, Polybase, MSDDC, and replication. One of our biggest feature areas in SQL Server 2019 is big data clusters. And this feature is fully based off of containers. Now, before we get into any demos, here's a quick recap of what a container is. In short, a container is an application packaged with all its dependencies, and it runs on the same kernel as other containers and processes. In contrast to VMs, the applications and its dependencies run on its own operating system and kernel. So on the left, you can see that SQL Server is running on top of its own set of dependencies, binaries, and libraries, and together that makes a container, and it runs on a host alongside other containers. On the right, you can see SQL Server with its dependencies running on top of its own operating system, and this is a VM. And it's typically sitting on top of a hypervisor, and then on top of a host machine. So given that a container is an application packaged with its dependencies that could run on any system, here are some of its characteristics. First of all, it's isolated, meaning that each container has its own set of dependencies not shared with other containers and is also unaffected at the runtime of other processes. It's also consistent. Every time you start a new container, it is using that same image, which starts in the same state that is defined in that container image. Third, it's portable. Because dependencies are packaged along the application, it makes it really easy to run this container across multiple hosts, whether it's on-premise or in Azure. It's easy to use and it's easy to start and stop. We'll see that shortly in the demo. And last but not least, there is no installation. SQL Server doesn't need to be installed within the container. It is ready to run as soon as the container image has been downloaded on the host machine. With that said, let's go ahead and switch over to my console here. And I'm going to show you how you can run a SQL Server 2019 container. So here on my console, I have a Docker run command, which will pull down a SQL Server 2019 container image from our Microsoft Container Registry and start the container. Right, so here you can notice that I have two environment variables. One of them is to accept the EULA, and the other one is to set the SSH password. So this is the same as SQL Server 2017 container images when you used it then. Then we have a port mapping, which maps the container external port as well to the internal port. And third, we're going to specify the container name, which is in this case SQL1. And last but not least, I'm going to specify the container image that I want to run. And in this case, it's going to be SQL Server 2019 latest. With that, let's run it. So I already had in this video, I already had the container pre-downloaded. And you can see that it has started up. So if I do a Docker PS, I can see that this container is already spun up. So what I just did was equivalent to a download install, right, which you would have done it on another system. So from here on in, you can use it like you would with any other SQL Server instance. So I'm going to go ahead and connect to this instance with Azure Data Studio. So I'm going to put localhost, as this is on my local machine. And then I'm going to enter the password that I just entered, that I used in my Docker run command. So with that, I am connected. And I'm going to just start a new query. I'm going to grab run some queries against this instance, and I can see that I am running SQL Server 2019, and I also queried the server name, which is the container ID of my instance. When I'm done, I can just go back to my console and spin this instance down with a docker remove command. And with that, I have spun down and removed my container instance. Right, so what I've just demonstrated was fairly easy of what I just mentioned before of one of the characteristics of how easy it is to start and stop a container instance. Now, what I just showed you was just a very simple scenario of how you can get a default SQL Server container with its default configurations. And I'd like to share with you on how you can get started and learn more. So on our docs.microsoft page, content page, we do have content on how you can get started with SQL Server containers. So this is a quick start page where we will provide you step-by-step walkthrough on how you can get started with SQL Server 2019 containers. All right. So we also have documentation on how you can configure your SQL Server container images. Right. So here we have a page with many different topics, such as running Red Hat-based container images, persisting your data with containers, and along with other various container topics. And last but not least, I would love to share with you our container lab, which we have on GitHub. So we have a lab here that covers the basics of using SQL Server containers, as well as how you can use SQL Server containers with an application spun up at the same time. All right, so all these links are provided in the description below, and that's it for now. I hope you can give SQL Server 2019 containers a try, and also check out other SQL Server 2019 videos on this channel to learn more about containers, as well as discover other cool, new and cool features. See you next time.